The story of FastAPI is, it's like so many parts. When I started working on like actually building FastAPI, I was just trying to solve the problem that I needed to solve in a way that was useful and efficient for me. I always expected that no one will pay attention, but actually like took off and people started liking it.
FastAPI.
It kept growing in GitHub stars and it was just like this steep line. My name is Sebastián Ramirez and I created FastAPI. I like to play around and say that I'm a kindergarten dropout, but it's actually not true. I'm a elementary first dropout. I was in a, you know, like regular Catholic school in Colombia, but I will ask too many questions. I was also like very curious about many different things, but I was not really enjoying the way that the school was working. So I ended up just like being homeschooled all my life. Having this mindset of liking to study and to understand how things work, I think that probably helped with FastAPI in that I was just trying to see like, is there any better way to do these things? When I started programming, I was always a consumer of open source. And then at some point, it was probably trying to solve a problem that I had with some open source projects somewhere and figuring out that it was actually for probably the first time, not my error, but there's actually something wrong in the tool. And I figured that I could help it with it and I could solve it. And I was trying to use the tools that I had at hand and trying to learn all the tools possible. And then learning the things that I liked about each one of those. I was actually convinced that there will be a tool that will have like all the things that I wanted. I was just trying to learn what was the right way to do it and what was the right tool. When I found one that was the closest to what I wanted, it was called API Star. And this was built by the same author that had built Django REST framework. And the author needed to stop working on that because the author was focusing on Starlet. That was this new framework that was in the newest standards and that had like a much better performance. I was also doing a bunch of front end and learning how the front end works and learning that all these type annotations were what provides auto-completion and inline errors. And I wanted to have that in Python. Then I figured that there was an alternative to Marshmallow called Pydantic that was at that time focused on validation of settings. So I wanted to combine Pydantic with the things on Starlet and build something together with that. At some point, I actually went to the GitHub issues in Starlet and I said, hey, I would like to build this thing that is pretty much, you know, like it's similar to API Star that was like by the same author. And I asked, would you like to have this in Starlet? And they said like, no, just like go build your own thing. So it was like, okay, I'm gonna build my own thing. And then I went and built FastAPI, mixing Pydantic and Starlet and putting all these things together. It was just trying to solve the problems that will come natural for building APIs, web APIs, using the new features of the language. Type annotations, async and await, and a bunch of different ideas from different tools like dependency injection. That's how it came to be. The name FastAPI, the word fast has actually like I guess multiple meanings. And I guess one very important one that people don't necessarily pay attention is that it's fast to build stuff with FastAPI. So you can like get something out the door very, very quickly. It's also fast in terms of performance and in terms of throughput. I wanted to build something that would appeal to myself when I was learning how to use these things. I wanted to build something that would be very simple to understand and to figure out how to use it. I was trying to solve the thing for me as a developer using FastAPI, not as the person that builds it, but as the person that uses it. So it was a lot of just like designing that developer experience before actually going and implementing the things underneath. FastAPI is built on top of type hints or type annotations. You can use type annotations to be able to just declare them once and then get multiple features out of that. You not only get auto-completion and inline errors, you also get data validation, data serialization, and documentation automatically based on just those same regular type annotations. The fact that FastAPI is by default is internally async is super important, and like in particular nowadays, than when we have applications and APIs that need to work with lots and lots of concurrent clients or concurrent users. When you build with FastAPI, you get an automatic documentation site for the API. I guess it's one of those things that for people that when people start working with FastAPI and they just like build, you know, like a tiny piece of code and they just go to /docs and they see this is all happening automatically, that's normally the moment of like, oh wait, I like this, what's happening here?
By now, you've probably heard that FastAPI is great.
I'm gonna be showing you the Python web framework known as FastAPI.
It's really fast. That's why it's called FastAPI.
The first sign that FastAPI was catching on was, I guess, GitHub stars. Then FastAPI was on, like, I don't know if Reddit or Hacker News or something, and then it suddenly grew in like a few days to 500 stars. Then it just kept growing, like a very high speed. And this was definitely not expected. FastAPI is currently used by so many companies like Microsoft, Uber, Netflix, Amazon, Meta, OpenAI. I don't know, the list just goes on and on. It's like all the big ones, but also all the small ones. It's used by so many people in so many places. It's also used for many things that are like super strange and super cool. So for example, the Webb Space Telescope, like this giant telescope in space, all the images and all the science data that is taken from the telescope is sent to Earth and then distributed across the world using FastAPI. They are using FastAPI, like discovering new drugs, tracking COVID, tracking wildfires, handling disaster recovery for the Red Cross. You know, like so many different things. I'm so happy to see that it's useful to so many people. I get so excited when people come and tell me like, hey, we are using FastAPI for this, or like we're using it for that. It was, you know, like it helped me find a job. It helped me solve like all these different types of problems. Every time that I hear someone telling me something like that, I get so happy and so excited. With FastAPI growing, the ideas that I brought into building APIs with FastAPI, I want to bring those same ideas and those same improvements into deploying FastAPI applications to the cloud. I would like to empower many people to build more stuff, to build more applications. Many people, many companies, many organizations, many different types of products that could be built. I like to help people help others with the tools. So that is in general what I am trying to do, just to help people be more efficient and generate value and solve problems for all their people around.